Welcome to the show. This is Community Mission's chance to talk about its programs. And with us today, we have people talking about two programs. One about Community Mission's Cabaret, and secondly, we will talk about the Art as Therapy. There, I need therapy. Therapy program. And with us, Judith Lee, who's here, Stephanie, and Sandy Crocker. So we're going to begin talking about the cabaret. And what is the cabaret, Judith?
The Sunday Cabaret is a program that has been created by the churches in Niagara County. Mm-hmm. It began with the Episcopal churches, and we've partnered with a number of different churches with Community Missions. On the last Sunday of every month, one church serves dinner in the community kitchen, and the other church plans a program for the evening.
And what are some of the programs?
We have had, there's a band, musical performances, the Celtic Fire, which is a popular local program, the Gospel Groove Band, the Gathering Band from Pendleton Methodist Church. We've had magician and artists come and do living art. We've had bingo and movie night. Mm-hmm. We've had a night of making cards and doing crafts and making collages. Mm-hmm. For that. The real idea is to, on the one hand, provide a normal fun night for families for whom the new normal doesn't allow necessarily a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And gathering. It's a chance for us to leave our own comfortable churches and dining rooms. Okay. And go and visit with somebody else in their dining room and their community room.
And who comes to these programs?
The clients are the people who are living in crisis housing. Mm-hmm. At Community Missions, and people from the community who come to use the who know of Community Missions. Mm-hmm. There's people who are participants in other Community Missions programs who are not living on site. Mm-hmm. Who come. Mm-hmm. For them. So it's a public program. It's not just members of Community Missions, but it's a way in which Community Missions has continued its partnership with other churches. Mm-hmm. To provide.
So what do the churches hope to get out of it?
The churches, partly it's fun. Mm-hmm. Partly I think the biggest thing for us is that we have gone out to someone else. It's one thing to say we welcome people to our kitchen or our parish hall. It's another thing to leave. Mm-hmm. That and go out to be somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Probably the biggest experience of transformation from people is to realize that there's no us and them. Mm-hmm. That those people. Mm-hmm. are very much like us. Uh-huh. We're together dining and entertaining each other. Mm-hmm. There's a larger, a deeper sense of community that goes beyond our church. Mm-hmm. Group. Mm-hmm.
What do you hope that, like, the people who come to these things, what do you hope they will get out of it?
Let's say I'm
in the crisis housing and I decide I'll check you out.
I hope that people come and have fun.
Okay.
For free, you know. Okay. Without any expectations on our part. You know. Mm-hmm. Just that they have fun and feel again that very often the people who come have lost a lot. Mm-hmm. And we can lose a lot and still stay who we are. Mm-hmm. And so I would hope that the people who come for an evening like this remember who they are. Mm-hmm. And in a way that can't ever be taken away. Mm-hmm. From them.
And you said it's Sunday night?
It's the last Sunday of every month. Dinner is served at the community kitchen at 5. Mm-hmm. And the program starts at 6.
What sort of, give me an example of what you would have for dinner. I'm always interested in
that
sort of thing.
Oh, the community kitchen. Well, and the other nice thing about this partnership is that it's allowed Community Missions to serve Sunday dinner. Mm-hmm. It's ranged from spaghetti and meatballs.
Okay.
To baked chicken or fried chicken. Mm-hmm. Comfort food, salad. Mm-hmm. Beverage, dessert.
Mm-hmm. And do you have
it's a cafeteria.
Adults, children?
Everybody mixes together. And one of the wonderful things about the program is for both the people who are coming to put on the programs and serve the meals, as you can see, I think, in a couple of the pictures of people who are serving the meals, the people who are coming to serve and the people who are coming to eat. Mm-hmm. It's all ages.
So, like, some of the churches who participated?
From the Episcopal churches from Lockport, Christ mm-hmm. Episcopal and Grace Episcopal from Niagara Falls, there's St. Stephen's and St. Peter's. Mm-hmm. From there's St. Paul's in Lewiston and St. John's in Youngstown, and then there's the two churches that I serve in central Niagara County, St. Andrew's mm-hmm. in Byrd and St. Mm-hmm. John's in Wilson. Bacon Memorial Presbyterian Church has been very active. First Presbyterian Church in Lewiston has uh-huh. been very active. United Baptist Christian Church in Lewiston has been very involved. Brighton Community Church in North Tonawanda has come mm-hmm. up and participated. Hope United Methodist, Pendleton United mm-hmm. Methodist.
Now, when a church participates, I mean, I guess you've got, what, people serving the meal, cooking the meal?
There's one church that serves the meal and prepares refreshments for the program.
Okay.
And then a second church designs and presents the program.
Oh, so you have two churches?
We have two churches on every Sunday evening. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we, you know, we've gotten a little teased a little about calling it a cabaret, but Episcopalians tend to be kind of straight-laced, as you can kind of tell from me, and the thought of Episcopalians and other churches getting together to present a cabaret is just irresistible.
Yeah, all so. I can think of is
yes,
Liza Minnelli singing
exactly.
cabaret. Yeah,
and that's a good program. And we've had some dancing too. So it really is, and it has built a really wonderful sense of community among the churches mm-hmm. where we know that. And
people, I credit any incidences or, you know, like people's comments or anything like that stand out in your mind when you think back over it. It's been going for a year, right?
We're beginning our third season.
Oh my gosh.
And what I remember is people saying over and over again what joy they experienced by being with people who were enjoying mm-hmm. themselves mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. with no other agenda mm-hmm. than to have fun together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Yeah, I think that's, I mean, having fun is so important in our lives.
We take it for granted sometimes. I think there's times when either we take it for granted or we feel we'll never have it again. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the cabaret kind of meets both of those.
And how long does it go on? I'm sure it varies, you know, from
time. Well, the goal is to finish by 7:30 because
okay.
there's families, children coming to both to both present the program and come for the program, so we want them to be home by 8. Mm-hmm. So the
well,
program
I know,
is
like in the homeless shelter, we have a lot of children. Mm-hmm. You know, it's it varies from time to time, but and then of course when we do the soup kitchen which we do at lunch mm-hmm. Especially in the summer, we get. Do people know ahead of time what your program's going to be?
Yeah, they do.
Okay, so they come prepared either for the magician
or
the music.
Musical entertainment
yeah.
or whatever.
Yeah, I know some of you had people doing the bells.
We had the bell choir come and play, and yes.
Yeah. Do you have any programs that seem to work better than others? I mean, like music programs versus. Handcrafts versus
No, I think they all depend on the full presence of the people who
right.
are doing them, and there's the share. So we really have tried to have variety more than any particular.
I'm trying to envision like you have all these tables there, and do you put like some church people and some people from the shelter.
Well, the people.
Or how do you do that?
Well, the entertainers are at the front of the room, and then the people who have come to either serve refreshments or accompany the performers sit at the tables with everybody's mixed.
So it's all mixed up.
It's all mixed up.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Mm.
As much as we can.
Wow.
You know.
Wow.
So it's just a wonderful evening.
Hmm. If say somebody that didn't know anything about it, let's say me. What would you say to me to sort of encourage me to come to the cabaret?
I would say come at, you know, it's the last Sundays. This coming September 28th, we're having the Gospel Groove Band from St. Andrew's come, which is mm-hmm. a Christian rock band made up of young people and adults, along with the Christian Baptist Church from Lewiston. I would say come and see what people are doing together. Mm-hmm. Come and meet some new people and have your heart lifted.
Yeah.
And
the first building that Community Missions had this sign: if you think you haven't a friend, come and let us prove you wrong. And I think that describes so well what you're trying to do.
That's a wonderful epigram for the cabaret, because that's what it is.
We didn't even know that we had that until one time a friend was looking at some of the old pictures, and then he got it like a microscope. What do you call those things? Something that makes the print look bigger. That, and so there, if you haven't a friend, come and let us prove you wrong. Such a nice sort of